during the last week. We've managed to fit in our maintenance on the greens, so all the greens have now been solid timed to a depth of 7 inches with our tractor mounted vertidrain. Then we've also gone behind with a Procore aerator, the pedestrian one, to about 4 to 5 inches. So we're, you know, putting lots of holes in it to allow us to get the oxygen into the profile and allow dressing to go in behind that to fill up the holes and level the surfaces. So all the greens were done in 2 days. We've also been working on winter tees. They're at this moment being hollow cored. Those cores will then be broken up and seed added and dressed into the profile to aid their recovery. Other jobs that we've been tackling on the golf course: irrigation system has been fully primed, so that's all up and working. We've tested it, every station's working. There's a few repairs to do on the system, which will be done over the next couple of weeks. All the sprinkler heads have been edged so that the pop-ups can work properly, and these also will be leveled on the greens. So for the irrigation system to be working at its optimum, we need the sprinkler heads to be level with the surface. So this is quite a big job. We have to dig out the sprinklers, re-level, and make sure they're all electrically working afterwards. So that's quite a big job that we've got at the moment. Other jobs that we've been doing: finishing off construction work. The bunkers that we were renovating over the winter, they have now been finished, sanded, and they'll be ready for play. Other tasks that we've also tackled: fairways. Over the winter, a lot of moss came into those, so we've managed to spray those with sulphate of iron, which we had in stock, which is quite a cheap way of treating the fairways. That'll knock the moss back, and then they will be raked and cut this week to aid their recovery as well. Small jobs to do on the golf course, plenty of cutting now, just setting up the golf course, areas starting to grow, plenty of spring renovation work.